In this lecture, we are going to discuss a few case studies on machinery fault diagnosis. The first one is the fault identification on a gearbox. So in general, the gearbox are subjected to two failures. One is bare tooth and the other one is broken tooth. Okay, in broken tooth, a part of the tooth will be broken. So here I have considered a fault that is broken tooth, and it is the experimental test rig. So here we have a VFD and a three-phase AC induction motor, then a gearbox, and I am going to monitor the vibratory signals of this gearbox, and a setup for applying the load is given here, okay, and it is supported in bearings. So we know that we have to measure the vibration in three direction. One is horizontal, vertical and axial. So in case of uniaxial accelerometers, we have to use three accelerometers to identify the, to measure the vibration. In case of triaxial sensor, one sensor is enough to measure the vibration in all the three directions. So here I am going to fix the accelerometer and the gearbox bearing. So I am going to measure the vibration signal. This is the time domain signal of a normal gear and a faulty system. So this is a standard. So always your fault free system is your standard. You have to compare the faulty system with your fault free system. So this is a standard normal gear vibration. So here you can see that. So small peaks and valleys are there, but not much peaks and valleys are there. If you look into the faulty system, then you can see that the signal has lot of peaks and valleys. So actually, if your system is 100% pure, then you will have a sinusoidal wave. But in universe, no system is 100% pure, so you will have small deviations. Okay. So as I discussed earlier, you can extract the features from the time domain as well as the faulty system and from the healthy system. For example, if the feature extracted from time domain is 9 mm per second, let us consider it's 9 mm per second, and definitely your RMS value from the faulty system will be greater than 9. It may be 12 or it may be 13. So in that case, what is our conclusion is, we can conclude that the RMS level of the healthy faulty system is high when compared to the normal system. So the system has some fault. So maybe at 1 PM it is around 12. If you measure the vibration signal at 2 PM, then it will be 14. Then at 3 PM it will be 16. So if you didn't identify the fault, then the amplitude levels will be increasing. Okay, so you have to compare the measured vibration signal with the standard signal, and you have to conclude that whether the system has a fault or not. So this is time domain analysis. So here we have identified that there is some fault in the system, but we cannot find what type of fault is there, and we have a lot of systems. You know, we have a bearing, we have a gearbox, and we cannot identify at which system the fault is occurred. Okay, so that is why we are going for frequency domain analysis. So before going to the frequency domain analysis, we have to identify the fault frequencies. So fault frequencies means, if the fault is occurred on the pinion, then you will have a peak value at the pinion fault frequency. If you have fault at wheel, then you will have a peak at wheel fault frequency. Okay, so for gear, the fault frequency can be identified by multiplying the number of teeth with the speed in RPS. So here actually in this case, the pinion has 20 teeth and the wheel has 40 teeth, and the system is running with 400 RPM. So which means it is 6.67 RPS. So multiplying 20 into 6.67, the pinion fault frequency is 133 Hz. Similarly, the wheel fault frequency is 266 Hz. So now we can convert the signal into frequency domain signal. This is for a normal gear. Okay, so you have a small peaks, but the amplitude is very low. It is 1600. But if you look into the faulty gear, then it is 3 × 10⁴. So the amplitude is high, and you have a peak value at, you can look into the hertz. So it is around 266. Okay. So we have calculated and see the peak value at gear fault frequency. So we have calculated two frequencies. One is the gear fault frequency and another one is pinion fault frequency. So 266 is the wheel fault frequency. So that is the fault frequency of the bigger gear. So which means the fault is occurred on the gear, not in the pinion. Okay. So if you look into the pinion fault frequency 133, you have a small peak, but the peak at the wheel is high, that is exactly at 266 hertz. Okay, so now I can conclude that the fault is there at the gear. So I don't need to disturb the other systems. So generally I can open the gearbox and I can replace the wheel. I don't need to check the motor, I don't need to check the bearing, I don't need to check the coupling. So this is the advantage of using vibration based condition monitoring. So you can act like a doctor. So a doctor will use a stethoscope to identify the fault. In case of vibration monitoring, you can use an accelerometer to identify the fault. So you don't need to dismantle each and every component. Okay, so in the doctor will not dismantle the human parts. So he will identify the fault by keeping some tests and with the help of his stethoscope. So that is how we have to act, and that is how we have to identify the fault. So the second case study is a bearing case study. So here a motor, a coupling, an accelerometer is fixed on the bearing, then we have a flywheel, then this is the second bearing. So here we have two fault. One is the fault at the outer race. So actually in bearings there are possibility for four fault. One is outer race fault and another one is inner race fault, then ball fault and the cage fault. So these are all the four common faults in your bearing. So here I have considered the outer race fault and ball fault. So we'll look into the time domain signal. So this is the time domain signal of a normal bearing, and this is the time domain signal for a bearing having outer race fault. So by time domain analysis we cannot conclude that, because there are so many peaks and valleys in the normal bearing also. But anyhow, if you take the RMS value, then the RMS value of the faulty system will surely be higher than the normal bearing. So normal bearing signal means, you may have a doubt, sir, what is meant by normal bearing and what is meant by faulty bearing? So normal bearing means, after purchasing the system we have to measure the vibration signal immediately after purchasing the system. So that is your normal bearing, that is kept as a standard, and when the system starts to rotate after some time, then you can measure the signal and you can consider it as a faulty signal. So these are all the four equations for calculating bearing fault frequencies. So BPFO for outer race fault and BPFI for inner race fault, BDF is for ball defect, and CDF for cage defect. So you can calculate the fault frequency of each component. So if the peak value of the frequency domain matches with the BPFO, then it means that the fault is there at the outer race. So if peak value has occurred at BPFI, then it means that the ball is having an inner race fault. I mean the bearing is having an inner race fault. So let us look into the frequency domain signal. So this is the frequency domain signal of a normal bearing, and this is in case of outer race fault. So in normal bearing we don't have any particular peak values, but if you look into the outer race fault, then we have a peak value here, and this frequency exactly matches with the BPFO. Okay, so which means the fault is there at the outer race. Okay, so actually in this case we have a fault at the outer race. So this method has clearly identified that fault. So for example, if you have a peak value at BPFI frequency, for example you have a peak here and it matches with BPFI, then it means that there is a fault at inner race. Okay, so this is how we have to identify the fault on bearing by using time domain as well as frequency domain. Then the last case study is unbalanced rotor or misalignment. So in general the rotors are subjected to two types of fault. One is unbalanced rotor and misalignment. So the crash crack is a rare one. So the most common one is the unbalanced rotor. Okay, so let us look into the acceleration position. So as I discussed earlier, it's a vertical transducer and a horizontal transducer. A tachometer is used to measure the speed. Fine, so this is the frequency domain signal. So I have directly converted the time domain signal into frequency domain signal. So this is for a fault free system. So I have a small peak value here, but the amplitude is very low. But if I look into the peak value of the unbalanced system, I have a tall peak at 1x RPM. So the fault frequency for unbalanced system is 1x RPM, which means if the system is vibrating with 30 Hz, then the peak value will be at the 30 Hz. So if you are rotating at your system at 600 RPM, then you can convert the RPM into Hz. If you have the peak value exactly at that converted Hz, then you can clearly identify that the system has a unbalance. So for gear, we have separate equation for calculating fault frequency. For bearing, we have separate equations for calculating fault frequency. In case of unbalance, it is very simple. It is 1x RPM, 1 into Hz. So here the system is rotating with 30 Hz and I have a peak value exactly at 30 Hz. So which means that the system is having an unbalance. Okay, so you can look into the unbalance, you can add the additional mass and you can neglect the effect of unbalance. Then in case of misalignment, you will have peak value at 1x and 2x. So for unbalance it is 1x RPM. In case of misalignment, we have peak values at 1x and 2x. So for example, here my system is rotating at 30 Hz. In normal system, I don't have any peak value. So a small peak is there, but the amplitude is very low. But if you look into the faulty system, that is the vibration signal taken after some times of machine operation. So this is the standard signal. So that is measured at the initial stage. So this is after some duration, the signal is measured. And here, I have a peak value at 1x RPM as well as I have peak value at 2x RPM. So if I have two peak values, then it means that the shaft has some misalignment. So you can identify the misalignment and you can neglect the misalignment. So these are all the various methods used in vibration based condition monitoring. But nowadays people are using time frequency domain analysis. That is an advanced one. And with that time frequency domain analysis, we can easily and effectively identify the fault by using the vibration signals. Okay, so there are plenty of journals are nowadays coming with the time frequency domain analysis. If you have interest, you can refer that.